You know when someone mentions cranial nerves and your farcical nerves, I mean facial nerves, fail to do what you want them to? Learning the location, course and branches of cranial nerves can make your optic nerves get super crossed. On top of that, you need to know how to pronounce their names properly. And there are so many nerves that really give your glossolalia pharynx, your gusophenixal nerve, oh boy! Well, don't you worry, because right now, we're going to tell you how to correctly pronounce the names of the 12 cranial nerves. And to make things even more interesting, we'll be reviewing some relevant information about each of these nerves. By the end of this video, you'll be able to say every word your hypoglossal nerve tells you to. First on the list, we have cranial nerve number 1, known as the olfactory nerve. The olfactory nerve is a special somatic afferent nerve which innervates the olfactory mucosa within the nasal cavity. It carries information about smell to the brain. Next on the list is cranial nerve number 2, also known as the optic nerve. The optic nerve is a special somatic afferent nerve which innervates the retina of the eye and brings visual information to the brain. Time now to look at cranial nerve number 3. The oculomotor nerve. The oculomotor nerve is both a somatic and visceral efferent motor nerve. This means it has two nuclei and carries two types of efferent fibers. As the name suggests, the oculomotor nerve is the chief motor nerve supplying the eye. Next up, cranial nerve number 4, the trochlear nerve. The trochlear nerve is a general somatic efferent motor nerve which originates from the midbrain. It enters the orbit through the superior orbital fissure, supplying one extra ocular muscle, the superior oblique muscle, thus playing a role in eye movement. Fifth on the list is the trigeminal nerve. The trigeminal nerve is a mixed nerve, containing both special visceral and general somatic fibers. The fibers originate from the brainstem, forming the trigeminal ganglion near the apex of the petrous part of the temporal bone. The trigeminal nerve divides into three divisions: the ophthalmic nerve, the maxillary nerve, and the mandibular nerve. Each of them leaves the skull through a different opening. The trigeminal nerve provides motor innervation to the muscles of mastication, the mylohyoid, the anterior belly of the digastric, and tensor tympani muscles. It also provides sensory innervation to the scalp, face, orbit, paranasal sinuses, and anterior two-thirds of the tongue. We're going to move on now to the next on our list, cranial nerve 6, known as the abducens nerve. The abducens nerve is a general somatic efferent nerve which originates from the brainstem and exits the skull via the superior orbital fissure. The abducens nerve innervates the lateral rectus muscle, an extra ocular muscle. Number 7 on the list is the facial nerve. The facial nerve is a multimodal nerve carrying both general and special fibers. It originates from the brainstem as two separate divisions, a larger primary root carrying motor fibers and a smaller intermediate nerve carrying sensory and parasympathetic fibers. The facial nerve provides sensory innervation to the middle ear, nasal cavity, soft palate, anterior two-thirds of the tongue and external auditory meatus. It also provides motor innervation to the lacrimal, submandibular, sublingual, and palatine glands, and the muscles of facial expression. Next, we will talk about the vestibulocochlear nerve. Cranial nerve 8 is a special somatic afferent nerve. It is comprised of two parts, the vestibular nerve and the cochlear nerve. The cochlear component enables hearing, while the vestibular part mediates balance and motion. At the fundus of the internal acoustic meatus, both parts unite to form the vestibulocochlear nerve and enter the cranium through the internal acoustic meatus. Time to look at cranial nerve number 9, the glossopharyngeal nerve. The glossopharyngeal nerve is another multimodal nerve. It originates from the brainstem and leaves the skull through the jugular foramen. It enables swallowing, salivation, and taste sensation, as well as visceral and general sensation in the oral cavity. Moving on now to cranial nerve number 10, the vagus nerve. The vagus nerve is also a multimodal nerve. It originates from multiple nuclei in the brainstem and exits the skull through the jugular foramen. It is the longest cranial nerve and the only one to leave the head and the neck region. The vagus nerve travels into the thoracic and abdominal cavities, providing parasympathetic supply to the visceral organs. Next on our list, the accessory nerve. Cranial nerve 11 is an efferent nerve originating from the brainstem and the spinal cord. The accessory nerve exits the skull through the jugular foramen, enabling phonation and movements of the head and shoulders. Last but not least, the 12th cranial nerve is the hypoglossal nerve. The hypoglossal nerve is a general somatic efferent nerve originating from the brainstem. It leaves the skull through the hypoglossal foramen, and its function is to enable tongue movements. And that's it! You've learned to pronounce all 12 of the cranial nerves.
Knowing how to pronounce these terms is one of the many things you need to do when learning human anatomy. So you're not done yet. Continue learning with our fun videos, interactive quizzes, detailed articles, and stunning atlas connected to these terms. Click on the button to find everything you need to become a master in human anatomy.